女士们、先生们、媒体朋友们，大家上午好。
Ladies and gentlemen, friends from the media, good morning.
昨天，任务总指挥部召开会议，研究确定了神舟16号载人飞行发射计划和航天员飞行乘组。今天，我们邀请到中国载人航天工程办公室副主任、工程新闻发言人林锡强先生给大家介绍情况，并回答各位感兴趣的问题。
Yesterday, the mission headquarters held a meeting to evaluate and confirm the launching plan of Shenzhou 16 spacecraft and its crew members. Today, we are pleased to have Mr. Lin Xiqiang, spokesperson of China Manned Space Program and Deputy Director General of China Manned Space Agency, to brief you about the relevant information and answer your questions.
首先，请林锡强先生介绍任务有关情况。
Now, I will pass the floor to Mr. Lin Xiqiang.
各位媒体朋友们，大家上午好。受任务总指挥部委托，由我向大家介绍神舟16号载人飞行任务有关情况。
Friends from the media, good morning. As commissioned by the mission headquarters, I take this chance to brief you about the Shenzhou 16 manned space flight mission.
经总指挥部研究决定，瞄准北京时间5月30日9时31分发射神舟16载人飞船。飞行乘组由航天员景海鹏、朱杨柱和桂海潮组成，景海鹏担任指令长。航天员景海鹏先后参加过神舟7号、9号、11号载人飞行任务，朱杨柱和桂海潮都是首次飞行。
As evaluated and decided by the mission headquarters, Shenzhou 16 manned spaceship is targeted to launch at 9:31 May 30 Beijing time. Crew members are astronauts 景海鹏、朱杨柱 and 桂海潮 with 景海鹏 as the mission commander. Astronaut 景海鹏 has flown Shenzhou 7, 9, and 11 manned space flight missions. 朱杨柱 and 桂海潮 will this time have their first space flight.
目前，执行此次发射任务的长征2号 F 遥16火箭即将开始加注推进剂。
Currently, Long March 2F-116 carrier rocket will be filled with propellant for this mission.
此次任务是载人航天工程今年的第二次飞行任务，也是空间站应用于发展阶段首个载人飞行任务。主要目的为完成与神舟15号乘组在轨轮换，驻留约5个月，开展空间科学与应用载荷在轨试验，实施航天员出舱活动及货物气闸舱出舱，进行舱外载荷安装及空间站维护维修等任务。
This mission is the second of this year's manned space flight and the first one of the space station application and development phase. Following main objectives are set.On-orbit crew handover with Shenzhou 15 crew, about 5 months stay on the space station, to carry out experiments and tests of space science and application payload, to perform extravehicular activities and cargo out tasks from airlock module, extravehicular payload installation and space station maintenance and repair tasks, etc.
按计划，神舟16号载人飞船入轨后，将采用自主快速交会对接模式，对接于天河核心舱径向端口，形成三舱三船组合体。在轨驻留期间，神舟16号航天员乘组将迎来神舟17号载人飞船的来访对接，计划于今年11月返回东风着陆场。
According to the plan, Shenzhou 16 spacecraft will perform, after entering the orbit, the the fast autonomous rendezvous and docking procedures. The spacecraft will dock with the Nidia port of the Tianhe core module to form a three module and three ship combination. During the stay, the Shenzhou 16 crew will welcome the visiting and docking of Shenzhou 17 manned spaceship. The crew are planned to return to the Dongfeng landing site in November this year.
目前，空间站组合体状态和各项设备工作正常。神舟16号载人飞船和长征2号 F 遥16运载火箭产品质量受控。神舟16号航天员乘组状态良好，地面系统设施设备运行稳定，发射前各项准备工作已就绪。神舟15号航天员乘组在与神舟16号航天员乘组完成在轨轮换任务后，返回东风着陆场。
Currently, the space station combination is in stable status with all equipment functioning well. Product qualities of Shenzhou 16 spaceship and Long March 2F116 carrier rocket are under control. The Shenzhou 16 crew is in good condition. Facilities and equipment of ground systems perform well. All pre-launch preparations are in order. Shenzhou 15 crew plans to return to the Dongfeng landing site after completing their on-orbit handover with Shenzhou 16 crew.
以上是这次任务的有关情况，下面我愿意回答大家的提问。
This is the brief of the mission. Now I'm glad to answer your questions.
下面请媒体朋友们提问。请这位记者朋友。
新华社记者提问，请问神舟16号乘组有哪些特点？为执行此次飞行任务做了哪些准备？未来会不会有越来越多的新人入选？谢谢。
I'm with 新华。What are the features of the Shenzhou 16 crew and what preparations have been made for this mission? Will there be more and more newcomers selected in the future? Thank you.
感谢你的提问。中国空间站已完成建造，进入应用于发展阶段。神舟16号乘组是该阶段迎来的首个乘组，由一名首批航天员和两名第三批航天员组成。其中，航天驾驶员景海鹏和航天飞行工程师朱阳柱来自航天员大队，主要负责直接操纵管理航天器以及开展相关技术试验。载荷专家桂海潮是北京航空航天大学的一名教授，主要负责空间科学试验载荷的在轨操作，在科学、航天工程等领域受过专业训练，且具有丰富的操作经验。
Thanks for your question. China Space Station has completed its construction and moved to the application and development phase. Shenzhou 16 crew is the first crew of this phase, consisting one first batch astronaut to third batch astronauts. Space pilot Jing Haipeng and flight engineer Zhu Yangzhu are from Astronaut Corps. They are mainly in charge of the direct operation and management of spacecraft, as well as conducting related technical tests. Payload expert Gui Haichao is a professor at Beihang University. He is mainly responsible for the on-orbit operation of space science experimental payloads and has professional training and experience in the field of science and astronautical engineering.
相比以往乘组，神舟16号乘组的特点可以用全、新、多三个字来概括。
Compared to previous crews, the Shenzhou 16 crew bears three features: comprehensive, new, and most.
一是全，首次包含了航天驾驶员、航天飞行工程师、载荷专家三个类型的航天员。
First, comprehensive. For the first time, a crew includes three types of astronauts: space pilot, flight engineer, and payload expert.
二是新， 第三批航天员首次执行飞行任务，同时也是航天飞行工程师和载荷专家首次执行飞行任务。
Second, new. It is the first flight mission of third batch astronauts and the first one of flight engineer and payload expert.
三是多，航天员景海鹏是第四次执行飞行任务，将成为中国目前为止飞迁次数最多的航天员。
Third, most.Astronaut 景海鹏 is on his fourth mission and will set record for most space flights in China to date.
自神舟十六号飞行乘组2022年6月确定以来，三名航天员全面开展了八大类200余项任务强化训练和准备，面向工程新阶段更大规模的在轨应用任务，重点加强了空间试验项目、空间站组合体管理和货物出舱等训练。
After the confirmation of Shenzhou 16 crew members in June 2022, three astronauts fully carry out eight categories of more than 200 intensive trainings and mission preparation, facing the large-scale in-orbit application tasks in the new phase of the project. They have received targeted training of space experiments and tests.Space Station Assembly Management and Payload Out Tasks.
首次执行任务的两名第三批航天员在乘组共同训练基础上，通过加强重点科目训练，进一步提升了操作和适应能力，为执行任务做好了全面准备。
On the basis of crew joint training, the two third batch astronauts who performed the mission for the first timefurther improve their operation and adaptability through targeted training of key subjects and made comprehensive preparations for the mission.
第三批航天员于2020年9月完成选拔，包括七名航天驾驶员、七名航天飞行工程师和四名载荷专家。经过两年多的刻苦训练，他们已完成了既定的训练内容，通过了飞行资格评定，均具备执行飞行任务的能力和条件。
In September 2020, China completed the selection of third batch astronauts, including 7 space pilots, 7 flight engineers, and 4 payload experts. After more than 2 years of hard training, they have completed the training plan, passed the flight qualification assessment.All have the ability and conditions to perform the mission.
第三批航天员均已开始空间站应用于发展阶段飞行任务的针对性训练，将成为我国载人航天工程后续飞行任务的中坚力量。可以说，未来肯定会有越来越多的新人入选飞行乘组，接续执行载人航天飞行任务。谢谢。
The third batch of astronauts will have started the targeted training for missions in the application and development stage of the space station and will become the backbone of the follow-up missions of China Manned Space Flight Project. It can be said that in the future, more and more newcomers will be selected for the flight crew and continue to carry out manned space missions. Thank you.
好，下一个问题。这位记者朋友，
谢谢主持人。人民日报记者提问：作为中国空间站进入应用与发展阶段的首次载人飞行任务，神舟十六号乘组将主要开展哪些工作？谢谢。
I'm with People's Daily. As the first manned spaceflight mission of CSS application and development phase, what are the main tasks of Shenzhou 16 crew? Thank you.
感谢你的提问。中国空间站进入应用于发展阶段，将常态化实施乘组轮换和货运补给任务。航天员乘组的在轨工作安排也将趋于常态化，主要包括六类任务。
Thanks for your question. China's space station has entered the stage of application and development. The crew rotation and cargo resupply will be implemented on a regular basis, and the on-orbit work schedule of the crew will also tend to be regularized, mainly including the following six tasks.
一是驾乘载人飞船交会对接和返回，辅助货运飞船、巡天望远镜等来访飞行器对接和撤离，确保人员物资正常轮换补给。
First, to operate the human spacecraft's rendezvous and docking and return, to support the docking and evacuation of cargo spaceship, survey telescope, and other visiting spacecraft, to ensure the normal rotation of personnel and materials resupply.
二是对空间站组合体平台的照料，包括飞行器状态设置、在轨物资管理、平台设备维护巡检、舱内外设备安装、载荷进出舱等工作，确保空间站平台安全稳定运行。
Second, the care of the space station assembly platform, including spacecraft status settings, in-orbit material management, platform equipment maintenance inspection, installation of equipment inside and outside the module, payload in and out tasks, etc., to ensure the safe and stable operation of the space station platform.
三是乘组自身健康管理，包括健康状态监测、在轨锻炼训练等，确保航天员在轨健康工作生活。
Third, the crew's own health management, including health status monitoring, in-orbit exercise training, etc., to ensure astronauts' healthy work and life in orbit.
四是进行在轨试验，利用空间站舱内外应用设施开展大规模科学研究与应用，确保发挥空间站应用效益。
Fourth, to carry out in-orbit experiments and tests, using the space station application facilities inboard and outboard, to carry out large-scale scientific research and applications, to ensure the application benefits of space station.
五是开展科普及公益活动，包括天宫课堂授课、公益视频拍摄等，最大化发挥空间站综合效益。
Fifth, to carry out popular science education and public welfare activities, including Tiangong classroom lectures, public welfare video shooting, etc., to maximize the comprehensive benefits of the space station.
六是进行异常情况处置，包括在轨故障的应急处置，对故障设备进行在轨维修更换，必要时通过出舱活动进行舱外维修作业，确保空间站能够长期稳定运行。
Six, the disposal of abnormal conditions, including the emergency disposal of in-orbit failures, in-orbit repair and replacement of faulty equipment,and extravehicular maintenance operations by EVA when necessary, to ensure the long-term stable operation of the space station.
具体到神舟十六号任务，将迎来两次对接和撤离返回，也就是神舟十五号载人飞船返回、天舟五号货运飞船的再对接和撤离，以及神舟十七号载人飞船对接。
To be exact, during the Shenzhou 16 missions, there will be two docking and evacuation returns, namely the return of Shenzhou 15 human spacecraft, the redocking and evacuation of Tianzhou 5 cargo spaceship, and the docking of Shenzhou 17 manned spacecraft.
将开展电推进气瓶安装、舱外相机抬升等平台照料工作，将完成辐射生物学暴露试验装置、元器件与组件、舱外通用试验装置等舱外 应用设施的安装，按计划开展多领域大规模在轨试验。
The installation of electric propulsion cylinders, extravehicular camera lift, and other platform car work will be carried out. The installation of large extravehicular application facilities, such as radiobiology exposure experimental devices, general test devices of extravehicular components and assemblies will be completed.And large-scale in-orbit experiments in multiple fields will be carried out as planned.
有望在新奇量子现象研究、高精度空间视频系统、广义相对论验证以及生命起源研究等方面产出高水平科学成果。
Which are expected to produce high-level scientific results in the study of novel quantum phenomena.Space hyperprecision time frequency systems, verification of general relativity, and the study of the origin of life.
还将开展天空课堂、太空授课活动，让载人航天再次走进中小学生课堂。此外，本次任务乘组由三类航天员构成，也将为后续任务安排积累经验。谢谢。
The Tiangong classroom teaching activities will also be carried out so that human spaceflight can once again enter the classrooms of primary and middle schools. In addition, this mission crew is composed of three types of astronauts for the first time and will also accumulate experience for the follow-up mission arrangement. Thank you.
好，下一个问题。这位记者朋友。
谢谢新加坡联合早报记者提问，可不可以请您介绍一下中国国际航天合作的进展以及下一步的规划？国外航天员的选拔以及进驻中国空间站的合作有哪些进展？我们预计什么时候可以看到外国的航天员进入中国的空间站？谢谢。
I'm with 联合早报。Can you tell us about the international cooperation arrangements and considerations of the project?Is there any new progress in the training of international astronauts and even the cooperation in entering the China space station? When can we see international astronauts in the space station? Thank you.
感谢你对工程国际合作方面的关注。探索未知宇宙，发展航天技术，是人类的共同事业。国际合作是航天发展的趋势潮流。在中国空间站建造建设过程中，我们始终坚持和平利用、平等互利、共同发展的原则，与多个国家和地区的航天机构和国际组织开展了形式多样的交流合作。
Thanks for your attention to the project's international cooperation. To explore the unknown universe and develop space technologyis the common cause of human beings. And international cooperation is the trend of space development. During the development and construction of China Space Station, we have always adhered to the principles of peaceful utilization, equality, mutual benefit, and common development, and have carried out various exchanges and cooperation with space agencies in many countries and regions and international organizations.
一方面，我们按照既定计划稳步推进已有的与联合国外空司、欧洲空间局等机构间的国际合作项目，陆续进入中国空间站开展试验，持续深化与已建立机制的合作伙伴关系。
On the one hand, we are steadily advancing our existing international cooperation projects with UNWSAT, ESA,and other agencies according to the established plan. We are carrying out these projects successively in China Space Station. We will continue to deepen partnerships with established mechanisms.
另一方面，我们积极拓展与新兴航天国家的合作交流，重点在空间科学试验与应用 中外航天员联合参与中国空间站飞行任务等方向。
On the other hand, we will actively expand cooperation and exchanges with emerging space countries, focusing on space station scientific experiments and applications, joint participation of international and Chinese astronauts in China space station missions.
此外，我们还积极参与空间环境治理、太空交通管理、空间资源开发利用等国际议题讨论和规则制定，为人类在外空领域应对共同挑战做出贡献。
In addition, we actively participate in discussions and rulemaking on international issues, such as space environment governance, space traffic management, space resources development and utilization, contributing to humanity's efforts to address common challenges in the field of outer space.
至于国外航天员的问题，中国空间站已转入为期十年以上的应用与发展阶段。我们拥有完备的近地载人空间站和载人天地往返运输系统。我们拥有成熟的航天员选拔训练和保障体系。载人飞行任务以每年两次的频率常态化实施，可以说完全具备开展相关工作的条件。
As for a question on international astronauts, China's space station has entered a stage of application and development for more than 10 years. We have a complete near-Earth human space station and human round-trip transportation system, a mature astronaut selection, training, and support system. Manned spaceflight mission will be carried out twice a year on a regular basis. It can be said that the conditions are fully equipedto carry out related work.
目前我们正在积极开展有关筹备，我也十分期待并欢迎国外航天员参加中国空间站飞行任务，谢谢。
Currently, we are also actively carrying out the relevant preparations. I also very much look forward to and welcome international astronauts to participate in China's space station mission. Thank you.
好，下一个问题。这位记者朋友。
好的，谢谢。总台央视记者提问，神十五乘组在轨工作生活已经有半年的时间，那么他们的工作完成情况如何？在返回之前，他们还要完成哪些任务？目前，我国前两批的在役航天员已经全部实现了飞天梦想，如果他们要再次进入太空的话，需要间隔多久？谢谢。
I'm with CMG CCTV. The Shenzhou 15 crew has been working and living on orbit for nearly half a year. How is their task accomplished? What other jobs are there before their returning? At present, the first two batches of Chinese astronauts in service have all realized their space dream. If these astronauts enter space again, how long will it take? Thank you.
感谢你对神舟十五号乘组的关心。去年十一月二十九日，神舟十五号飞船发射入轨。目前，航天员乘组已在轨工作生活一百八十一天，各项在轨工作进展顺利。
Thanks for your concern for Shenzhou 15 crew. On November 29th last year, Shenzhou 15 spacecraft was launched into orbit. At present, the astronaut crew has been working and living in orbit.For 181 days, whereas in orbit work is progressing smoothly.
他们已圆满完成了四次出舱活动任务，成为执行出舱任务次数最多的乘组。
They have successfully completed four EVA missions, becoming the crew with the highest number of EVA.
还开展了多次载荷出舱任务。八项人因工程技术研究，二十八项航天医学试验，以及三十八项空间科学试验，涵盖了生命生态、材料科学、流体力学等， 获取了宝贵的试验数据。
They have also carried out several payload out missions, 8 human factors engineering technology studies, 28 space medical experiments, and 38 space science tests and experiments, covering the fields of life ecology, material science, hydromechanics, etc., and acquired valuable experiment data.
目前，他们正在紧张有序地开展神舟16号乘组进驻和神舟15号飞船返回前的各项准备工作。在神舟15号乘组返回前，他们需要持续开展部分空间科学在轨试验，完成返回前试验样本采集、处置和下行物品的清点整理。待神舟16号乘组进驻后，两个乘组完成在轨交接和轮换之后返回地面。
At present, they're carrying out the preparation work before the Shenzhou 16 crew's moving in and Shenzhou 15 spacecraft's return in an intense and orderly manner. Before the return of Shenzhou 15 crew, they need to continue to carry out part of the space science in-orbit experiment and test, complete the collection of experiment samples before returning, disposal and inventory of download items,After the moving in of Shenzhou 16 crew, the two crews will complete the handover and rotation in orbit. Then Shenzhou 15 will return to the ground.
作为大家口中的圆梦乘组，他们将为祖国和人民交上一份满意的圆梦答卷。
As the dream crew, they will deliver a satisfactory dream answer sheet to our motherland and people.
执行长期在轨飞行任务的航天员返回地面后，通常需要六个月左右的时间进行飞行后的身体状态恢复。经评估满足条件后，航天员就可以转入正常的工作和训练状态，参与下一轮飞行乘组选拔。
After returning to the ground from a long-term mission in orbit,Astronauts usually need 6 months to recover from their post-flight physical condition. And after their conditions are assessed to be met, the astronauts can be transferred to normal work and training status to participate in the next round of flight crew selection.
入选后一般经过一到一年半左右的训练即可再次执行飞行任务。我相信在后续的飞行任务中很快就能看到他们的身影。
After being selected, they're generally ready to fly again about 1 to 1.5 years of training. I believe that we will see them back in space soon in follow-up missions.
好，下一个问题。好，这位记者朋友。
谢谢。中国日报记者提问。那么现在呢，中国的空间站已经全面建成，我想请问发言人，我们工程下一步的发展目标是否是载人登月？那么如果是的话呢，我想知道就是咱们中国的航天员什么时候可以登上月球？谢谢。
I'm with China Daily. At present, the China Space Station has been fully built. It's the next development goal of the project to land human on the moon. If so,When can we see Chinese astronauts land on the moon?
感谢你的提问。嫦娥奔月在中国是家喻户晓的神话传说。可上九天揽月是中华民族敢于战胜困难、勇于挑战自我的生动追求。目前，中国已全面建成并开始运营空间站，但中国人探索太空的脚步还将迈得更远。
Thanks for your question. 嫦娥 flying to the moon is a household legend in China. To embrace the moon from the night heaven is the vivid portrait of Chinese people who dare to overcome difficulties and challenge themselves. At present, China has fully completed and started to operate the space station, but Chinese people will explore the space further.
近期，中国载人月球探测工程登月阶段任务已启动实施，总的目标是2030年前实现中国人首次登陆月球，开展月球科学考察及相关技术试验，突破掌握载人地月往返、月面短期驻留、人机联合探测等关键技术，完成登、巡、采、研、回等多重任务，形成独立自主的载人月球探测能力。
Recently, the mission of Human Lunar Exploration Project in China has been launched and implemented. Following main objectives are set. By 2030, Chinese people will land on the moon for the first time, carry out lunar scientific research and related technical testing, break through and master key technologies such as Earth-Moon Human Round Trip, Lunar Surface Short-Term Stay,Human-robotic joint exploration. We will complete the multiple tasks of landing, orbiting, sampling, research, and return, and form an independent human lunar exploration capability.
将推动载人航天技术由近地走向深空的跨越式发展，深化人类对月球和太阳系起源与演化的认识，为月球科学的发展贡献中国智慧。
Promote the leapfrog development of human space technology from near Earth to deep space. Deepen human understanding of the origin and evolution of the moon and the solar system. And contribute Chinese wisdom to the development of lunar science.
针对这一目标，中国载人航天工程办公室在前期关键技术攻关和方案论证的基础上，已全面启动部署研制建设工作。
In view of this goal, the CMSA office has comprehensively deployed and carried out various research and development work on the basis of preliminary key technology research and program demonstration.
包括研制新一代载人运载火箭，也就是长征十号运载火箭，新一代载人飞船、月面着陆器、登月服等飞行产品，新建发射场相关测试发射设施设备等。
Including the research and development of a new generation of human launch vehicles, namely 长征10.A new generation flight products including human spacecraft, lunar surface landers, lunar landing suits, etc., and new launch set related tests and launch facilities and equipment.
后续，我们将强化科学管理，强化竞争择优，强化开放合作，扎实推进各项研制建设工作，确保如期实现中国人登陆月球的目标。
Subsequently, we will focus on scientific management, competition and selection, open cooperation, and solidly promote the development and construction work to ensure that the goal of landing Chinese people on the moon will be achieved on schedule.
此外，针对载人登月任务、科学载荷、载人月球车方案征集，新一代载人飞船、月面着陆器名称征集等，我们将陆续发布相关公告，敬请媒体朋友们继续关注，谢谢。
In addition, we will release relevant announcements for the call for proposals on scientific payloads and human lunar rover program, and call for names for the new generation of human spacecraft and lunar lander, etc.We will post relevant notice later. Please stay tuned. Thank you.
好，下一个问题。这位记者朋友。
谢谢。香港大公文会记者，中国的第四批预备航天员已经启动选拔了，能不能仔细的详细的介绍一下他们的这个选拔情况，尤其是港澳地区参与这个中国航天员载荷专家的选拔情况是怎么样的，还有他们这个港澳地区的航天员最快能够什么时候能够参与到我们的中国空间站中？谢谢。
I'm with 太空文卫。The selection of the fourth batch of preparatory astronauts in China has started. How is it going so far? Can you tell us more about the selection? In particular, the progress of the selection of payload experts from Hong Kong and Macau. When can we expect to see Hong Kong and Macau astronauts' participation in space station missions at the earliest?
谢谢你的提问。为满足载人航天工程后续任务需要，中国第四批预备航天员选拔已于去年全面启动。按照初选、复选、定选三个阶段组织实施，计划选拔12到14名预备航天员，包括航天驾驶员、航天飞行工程师和载荷专家三类，并首次在港澳地区选拔载荷专家。
Thanks for your question. In order to meet the needs of follow-up missions of manned space project, China's fourth batch of preparatory astronaut selection has been fully launched last year. In accordance with the primary selection, re-election, final selection of three stages of organizations and implementation, we plan to select 12 to 14.Preparatory astronauts, including space pilots, flight engineer, and payload experts. For the first time, we will select payload experts in Hong Kong and Macau.
截至2023年3月，已完成初选选拔工作，共有100多名候选对象进入复选阶段。
By March 2023.The primary selection has been completed, and more than 100 candidates have entered the re-election stage.
其中，航天驾驶员来自陆、海、空三军现役飞行员，航天飞行工程师和载荷专家主要来自工业部门和高等院校，特别是有10余名来自香港和澳门地区的候选对象进入了复选。
Among them, space pilots are active pilots of the armed forces. Flight engineers and payload experts are mainly from industry and universities. In particular, more than 10 candidates from Hong Kong and Macau have entered the re-election.
总体来看，四选工作正在按计划有序推进，计划今年年底前完成全部选拔工作。
Generally speaking, the fourth batch selection are progressing in an orderly manner as planned, and all selections are planned to be completed before the end of this year.
如果港澳地区的候选对象通过复选和定选，可于明年初进入航天员科研训练中心。目前看，一般要经过2年半左右的训练，通过考核后具备执行飞行任务的基本条件。但具体执行飞行任务的时机，要根据飞行任务总的规划、要求，以及空间应用项目进展情况等统筹确定。谢谢。
If candidates from Hong Kong and Macau could pass the re-election and final selection,They will enter the Astronaut Research and Training Center in the beginning of next year. Generally, they will spend about 2.5 years on training and pass the assessment to be qualified to carry out flight mission. However, the timing should be considered according to the general planning, mission requirements, and the progress of the space application project. Thank you.
好，最后一个问题啊。好，这位朋友。
谢谢主持人，我是中央广播电视总台中国之声的记者。请问发言人，在中国空间站全面建成进入应用与发展阶段后，工作和任务安排是怎样的？谢谢。
I'm with China National Radio. May I ask the mission arrangement after the space station is fully completed and enters the application and development stage?
谢谢你的提问。目前，空间站已全面建成，进入为期十年以上的应用与发展阶段。在这一阶段，航天员将长期连续驻留空间站，通常每年进行两次乘组轮换，一到两次物资补给。在确保空间站安全稳定运行的基础上，应用于发展阶段主要任务可以从应用与发展两个方面来概括。
Thanks for your question. Currently, the space station has been fully completed and has entered an application and development phase lasting more than 10 years. In this phase, astronauts will stay on the space station continuously for a long duration, normally with two crew rotations and 1 to 2 cargo resupply every year. On the basis of ensuring the safe and stable operation of space station,The main tasks of application and development phase can be summarized in 2 aspects, application and development.
在应用方面，为促进我国空间科学、空间应用、空间技术全面发展，我们将充分利用空间站目前已配置的舱内试验柜和舱外载荷，以及巡天空间望远镜等设施设备，滚动实施空间生命科学与人体研究、微重力物理科学、空间天文与地球科学、空间新技术与应用等四个专业领域近千项科学研究与应用项目，开展较大规模的空间科学试验与技术试验。
In terms of applications, in order to promote the comprehensive development of China's space science,space application and space technology. We will make full use of inboard experiment racks, outboard payloads, survey telescope, and other facilities already installed on space station to implement nearly 1,000 scientific research and applications on a rolling basis in the following 4 fields. Space life sciences and human research, microgravity physical science, space astronomy and earth science,New space technology and applications. We will carry out large-scale space science experiments and technology testing.
我们近期将面向社会公开发布载人空间站应用于发展阶段科学与应用项目征集公告和指南，持续开展项目征集工作，不断扩大项目征集范围，力争尽快实现空间站应用资源满载运行，持续产出高水平应用成果。
We will publicly release the announcement and guidelines for the call for scientific and application projects of the application and development phase of space station. Through continuous call for projects and expanding the scope, we strive to achieve full operation of space station application resources as soon as possible.And consistently produce high-level application results.
在发展方面，为进一步提升工程近地轨道综合能力和技术水平，我们将统筹载人月球探测任务，研制可重复使用的新一代近地载人运载火箭和新一代近地载人飞船。
In terms of development, to further enhance the comprehensive capability and technology of the project in near-Earth orbit, we will coordinate the human lunar exploration mission, develop a new generation of reusable near-Earth human launch vehicles and a new generation of near-Earth human spacecraft.
为进一步支持在轨科学试验，为航天员的工作和生活创造更好的条件，将适时发射扩展舱段， 将空间站基本构型由 T 字形升级为十字形。
To further support scientific experiments in orbit and to create better working and living conditions for astronauts, we will launch extended module in due course and upgrade the space station from T-shape to cross-shape.
为进一步降低空间站上行货物运输成本，增强上行货物运输的灵活性，我们已面向全社会发布征集空间站低成本货物运输系统总体方案公告，后续将择优开展低成本货物运输系统研制及飞行验证。谢谢。
To further reduce the cost and enhance the flexibility of cargo upload transportation, we have issued a call for proposals for the overall low-cost cargo transportation system for the space station.And will subsequently carry out the development and flight verification of the best solutions. Thank you.
感谢林希长先生的介绍和回答。关于工程建设和后续任务的最新进展，我们将通过新闻媒体和载人航天工程官方网站继续发布。感谢大家对中国载人航天事业的关注和支持。新闻发布会就到这里。让我们共同预祝任务圆满成功，谢谢。
Thanks for Mr. Lin Xiqiang's introduction and answers. On following project construction and mission progress, we will continue to post through media and CMSA official website. Thank you for your concern and support for China's manned spaceflight course. This is the end of the press meeting. Let's wish a complete success for this mission. Thank you.
我们在52台被撤照，我们在 YT 被限流、被黄标，我们在脸书被检举、被降触及，这些我们都遭遇过，但我们不放弃，让真相被听见、被看见。我们现在有自己的中天新闻网 APP， 这里永远不断线，请你赶快下载中天新闻网 APP。 这个 APP 好贴心，中天的新闻直播和节目全部都在里面，一次满足。